So you guys, today's video, I'm going to be talking about Julian Newman and Emmanuel Maldonado. Now, I want to bring y'all this video just because I want to explain to you guys on why Julian and Emmanuel both did not become Division I players. We all know they used to be former teammates playing for Prodigy Prep, but it seems like both of them will not be taking the college route for their basketball careers. So before I start this video, make sure you guys go follow me on Instagram at _TheOnlyWallace, and also go subscribe to my second channel called Ticket Wallace Vlogs. Now let's get to the video. So first thing first, let's talk about Emmanuel Maldonado. So we all know Emmanuel just recently graduated from high school in the class of 2021, attending Team Dynasty Academy. But here's the thing. So when I did some research on Team Dynasty Academy, I'm not 100% sure if that's an actual school. I think it's something similar to Prodigy Prep. We all know Prodigy Prep was like a little academy, and they only held it for 1 year for Julian Newman's senior year. So as you can see, for Emmanuel Maldonado's senior year, he attended Team Dynasty, and yeah, but it seems like it's an actual academy, because the thing about Prodigy Prep, we all know that was set up just for Julian Newman so he can get some more recognition, so he can make it to college and stuff like that. Because as you can see right now, where's Prodigy Prep? There's no academy going on. There's nothing. They just still having it as a brand. So that shows us that it was literally just for Julian Newman. So for Emmanuel Maldonado, it seems like he did the same thing for his senior year. He just went to a different academy. But when you look at his sports profile, it says that he attends Colonial High School in Orlando. So I'm not 100% sure if he just take online classes with that school, and that's probably the school he graduated from, and he was just playing games with Team Dynasty Academy. I'm not 100% sure on what was going on for his senior year, but all I know is he signed to overtime, which means he lost all of his college offers and he cannot play in college. And I'm going to explain to you guys on why he can't no more. So if you guys do not know, Emmanuel Maldonado is currently holding an offer from Bethune-Cookman University, and he also have interest with schools such as Vanderbilt, Georgia Tech, Iowa State, Kansas State, and Florida Gulf Coast. So as you can see, there's a lot of Division I schools that actually had their eyes on Emmanuel Maldonado, and they just wanted to see him progress his game. After his junior year, when he left Prodigy Prep, that's when Vanderbilt really started to pay more attention to Emmanuel Maldonado and just figure out if they really want to send him an offer and stuff like that. Because honestly, we all know Emmanuel always been like that. When he was attending Prodigy Prep, he was the best player on the team. But all the spotlight was on Julian Newman, because like I said, that whole academy was set up for Julian Newman so he can make it to college. But as you can see, it still didn't work out for him. And that's why Emmanuel had to leave, because he knew he had one more year and he had to figure out what was the best option for him. So him going to a different academy, that's why he got more recognition from different schools. Ball his life, over time, they started to pay more attention to him, pull up to his games more, and just give him the recognition that he deserved. And that's why I started to make more videos on Emmanuel myself, because I was watching him when he was attending Downey Christian and Prodigy Prep, and I realized that everybody was paying attention to Julian Newman. And I knew Emmanuel was like that. After I see him like throw the ball between LaMelo legs when they played against Spire that year, and he was really just cooking them, shooting threes back to back, and just really being consistent with his game. I knew Emmanuel was like that. He just needed that spotlight, and he finally got it. Because if you guys do not know, he just recently signed with Overtime Elite. They sent him an offer for their new fall league, and he's going to be getting paid around like 6 or 7 figures. So you already know he's going to be getting bank. He was really extremely happy on his Instagram story. He even made a post. He was like, the bag secured. So you already know he's extremely happy, because he's going to be getting paid straight out of high school, which is really, really good. I'm actually really proud of Emmanuel for just being in this situation for his basketball career already, as in coming straight out of high school and getting paid bank. You already know if Julian Newman was still in high school, he will be doing the same thing, going to this Overtime Elite league and playing with Emmanuel Maldonado. I know Julian actually wish he was still in high school, because this is the first year they started this new league, and you already know Julian Newman, he's affiliated with Overtime, so of course they would have offered him a contract too. And you already know Julian would have took that. He would have went straight to that Overtime league, and right now he would be running with them with Emmanuel Maldonado. So I know Julian kind of mad about that, but at the end of the day, he just got to focus on him. But we're going to talk about Julian. Let's stay focused on Emmanuel. So like I said, he signed to this Overtime Elite, and he will be getting paid with them, which means he is not eligible to play college basketball with the NCAA. We all know their rules. He just signed the contract with Overtime, so all of his offers are gone, basically. Vanderbilt, they're not going to be looking at him no more. Georgia Tech, not going to be looking at him no more. Iowa State, Kansas State, his offer for Bethune-Cookman is probably gone, and he actually probably got more offers I don't know about, but all I know is his college eligibility is gone just because he signed this contract, which means he is not going to become a Division I player just like Julian Newman. So Julian and Emmanuel both did not get to make it to college and play Division I basketball, you guys. So that's the reality of their situation right now. But honestly, the good thing about Emmanuel is that he's actually a professional athlete. He get to run with Overtime Elite. He's already getting paid. And he also is going to be representing Puerto Rico for the U19 World Cup. So Emmanuel, he got some stuff going on for himself. And, you know, his future is actually still looking bright because most likely he can still play like overseas somewhere or anything. All he doing is playing for Overtime Elite for this 1 year, basically for his college year. Then after that, you never know. It depends on how good he played with Overtime. He might can get an offer from an overseas team or something. So I'm going to keep you guys updated with Emmanuel Maldonado's basketball career. And for Julian, I've been paying attention to him too. I know a lot of people actually been wanting me to make more videos on Julian for some reason. But it seems like Julian just been doing his thing. He's been working out and just been working on his brand. So we all know Julian Newman, he's just been doing his thing. I'm not 100% sure on what's going on with his professional situation. The last time he even spoke on his basketball career, such as him going overseas, he said that he received interest from teams overseas in Australia, Japan, and France. And since then, we still have not heard nothing. So we still waiting to see what's going to happen. But I want you guys to leave y'all comments and opinions below on how y'all feel about Emmanuel signing to Overtime Elite. And how do y'all still feel about Julian Newman? I thank you guys for watching. Please make sure you like and subscribe. Make sure you press the notification button. T Gang, we out. Thank you.